It's good, man. I hope all the fine girls watch this video. Let's get it, man. When disrespecting your opponents goes too far, man. Let's get right into it, man. I hope y'all having a great 2024, man. Plenty more Rick coming to y'all, man. I hope y'all enjoy y'all days and make sure to live life to the fullest.
This is Naoya Inoue. He's a knockout artist from Japan, and he's pissed. Naoya is mad because 3 days earlier, his opponent's coach threatened and pushed his coach, who just so happens to be his father. The thing is, Inoue is as humble as they come. He doesn't talk trash, he never causes drama, he just shows up and knocks people out. But after a member of his family was shoved for no reason, the fight became personal. His opponent may not have been the one to push his dad, but he was about to receive all the consequences.
From Inoue, this is a fearsome flurry, and he's down. He's got him with a left for the first time in his career.
Trash talking between boxers is common, but if you take shots at their coach, who's often their father or a father-like figure, it's not going to end well. Remember when Caleb Plant tried to rile up Canelo's team? Coach Eddie Reynoso was just minding his business and ended up catching some strays.
Mark my words, you bitch, and you a bitch too. You know the only difference between you and him is he's a fat ass bitch and you a bitch. What the fuck you gonna do? Fuck you.
Tensions boiled over during the stare down when Canelo shoved Plant for his comments. A retaliatory slap was thrown, dodged, and countered, leaving Plant with a cut under his eye. All beef aside, Canelo's defense and counter left slap here was pristine. World-class slapboxing. Anyway, Plant had insulted his entire camp, Canelo drew first blood, and the fight was still over a month away. Real hate and all four belts on the line? This was gonna-
Bro, that Canelo fucked him up. Like, that's how you know you don't even wanna fight Canelo.
Be a good fight.
And is not the same. Ooh, just got hurt.
Oh, and that was the first time I seen Canelo be aggressive as fuck.
Alright, well, don't talk trash next time. Canelo was crowned the undisputed champion, and it was actually Eddie Reynoso's birthday, so you know they had to celebrate. When all four belts are on the line, fighters will say anything to get in their opponent's head. Errol Spence and Terrence Bud Crawford had been going at it for years, but the Texan boxer specifically had it out for Bomac, Crawford's head trainer. Bomac was the recipient of a number of fat jokes leading up to the fight, and his failed boxing career only added fuel to the fire. McIntyre's best night was a unanimous decision loss to Butterbean, and after getting knocked out 5 times in a row, he retired to become a coach. Contrast this with Spence's coach, who had a decent career and even challenged for a couple regional titles. The trash talk practically wrote itself, but Crawford and his coach have always had an Omaha versus everybody mentality. Bomac knew Bud his entire life, trained him his entire career, and guided him to the sport's peak. Crawford could hardly be criticized, but his coach? Definitely.
He was a 5'7 super heavyweight, weighing 300 some pounds. Like, you not disciplined, so how you gonna tell other fighters to be disciplined when you not disciplined?
Errol's got a point. What could an overweight, failed boxer possibly teach Terrence Crawford to beat him? Well...
Back comes Crawford with a jab. Floyd tells him he's stumbling and he hasn't been hit. Here comes Spence though as Crawford and down the seventh. A big shot! It's hurt again. A right hook that wobbles him. Spence might be going down again.
I don't know if Bomac is a boxing genius, but insulting him is like insulting Crawford's family. Bud went in there and gave Spence the beating of a lifetime. It was personal. Crawford was crowned the undisputed champion, and Bomac had a lot to say. But fat jokes are just that, jokes. What happens when a fighter actually crosses the line? In the run-up to Manny Pacquiao vs. Antonio Margarito, Margarito's camp mocked Manny's longtime friend and trainer, Freddie Roach. Roach has Parkinson's disease, which means he struggles with uncontrollable shakes and tremors.
Hi, Freddie Roach. No. Yes. No.
There's Freddie Roach right there.
Manny Pacquiao.
This video leaked in the midst of Margarito trying to clear his reputation after putting plaster in his hand wraps. Margarito's team scrambled to apologize as the video went viral, but it was too late. Manny wanted revenge.
The action, Pacquiao hits a block with a big left.
Pacquiao's beginning to land with almost every punch.
Physically strong.
And has to, but he's beating Margarito up in this round.
And here comes
Manny badly. Hits him again with the left. Margarito not. I want to use it as a target.
Physically fatigued both. And this
he's ready to go, even though he's hopelessly behind and getting
no head movement at all.
Despite being nearly 20 pounds lighter, Pacquiao in his 8th division beat the brakes off Margarito. He broke his orbital bone, bloodied his face, and pleaded with the ref to stop the fight. This was an all-time whooping. Oh, and the other guy making fun of Roach in the video? 3 years later, Brandon Rios would get humbled too. You'd think his team would have learned to not mess with Freddie Roach after Pacquiao effectively ended his buddy's career. But after more Parkinson's taunting and a kick to Roach during a gym dispute, Manny once again had to teach them a lesson. Roach told the Associated Press, "Pacquiao said to me, 'Are those the guys that made fun of you?' And I said yes, and he said, 'That's all I need to know.'" Pacquiao's speed was too much for Rios to handle, and he beat him up for 36 minutes straight. A knockout would have been too lenient. 12 full rounds as a punching bag was much better payback for his coach. Let this be a lesson. You're already going to war against the champion. Why give him extra motivation to knock your head off? Inoue was the challenger, and Rodriguez was the champion. He was furious at how they treated his father, but he had to stay composed for the fight. If Team Inoue was mad, their professionalism hit it well. When asked about the push, Noya's father Shingo simply said, "That was very ungentlemanlike." The bell rang, and it was time for vengeance. It took Inoue all of one round to completely figure out his opponent's timing and distance. He was just too fast. And after tasting Inoue's power, Rodriguez knew his only chance of survival was to stand and bang. And that's something you just can't do with Inoue.
Fearsome flurry, and he's down!
Inoue floored the Puerto Rican for the first time in his career. He got up, but the worst had yet to come. Two aching body shots had Rodriguez doubled over on his knees. Punches so hard, the thuds could be heard over the official broadcast.
Here comes Inoue!
With a bloody nose and a failing liver, he pleaded with his corner to not throw in the towel. But a part of him had to be thinking, what the hell did you shove his dad for? And if that wasn't enough punishment, one more left hook to the body put him down for good. Noya Inoue took his belt, avenged his father, and scored a highlight reel knockout, all in under 2 rounds. He could have went back upstairs and headhunted for a knockout, but his intention was to deliver maximum pain. Body shots will do that. In an interview after the fight, Inoue said, "The Puerto Rican coach had no respect for my father. This is why I decided to jump right to knocking out Emmanuel Rodriguez, to hit him in a vindictive way." Inoue got his revenge, a new belt, and set up his next fight for the Unified Championship. Rodriguez, on the other hand, had to rebuild, and his first move? Fire the trainer that started all of this. He may not have known it at the time, but with a single shove, he awoke the monster from Japan and ended up giving his fighter liver damage. Naoya Inoue looked unstoppable. With his speed and power, the division was wide open for the taking. But in his next fight, he encountered something that rocked him to his core. Check out this video to see what happened and how a true champion deals with adversity.